What is good, friends? We are back with World Cup round one. We got updated Canada's FLCL, and he did bring, I assume that's just a standard defensive Clefable. He could either be Zim of Land or Zygarde. I assume he's gonna be, but he kind of needs a thousand arrow switch. I mean, yeah, Clef is a thousand arrow switch. So his Landorus could be offensive, but Landorus the only rock, so I'm thinking it's defensive Landorus. Makes a bit more sense to me. FLCL's team looks like the standard Brofist team that has been spammed, but he put a Mega Pinsir on there. Instead of what? What was there in that slot? I forgot. At least I have a Mew. I assume we're gonna see the Clefable come out here on a Will-O-Wisp. He might also just go for Ice Beam. I could see the Torm being like Life Orb and the Magearna being Assault Vest on his team. Like, on the, this team. It does go on a Clef on an Ice Beam. That shouldn't do much at all. Hopefully no Freeze. Nice. I mean, yeah, he could still be Rocks Clef. Did I earlier say he's Rocks Lando? He can obviously still be Rocks Clef. I know why I'm lagging, let me close my Discord. But yeah, do exchange rocks. And if this Clef has a knockoff, that's a fine play to make here. Otherwise, you can just spam Moonblast or Flamethrower, whatever he has. Like, if he has Flamethrower, he can click that too. Flamethrower, that would have been nice, but yeah. Like, since Torn might have knockoff, so this Clef might not be knock. Because the max defense set can like take Bullish Punch from Scizor with ease if Scizor's not SD. But yeah, he's gonna go into, I think, his own Assault Vest. If he's Assault Vest, he's gonna go into his own Magearna. Yeah, if he's AV Torn, he can go Torn, but I think he's AV Mag. I mean, he can also be, oh, he was fast. Is it Trick Room Magearna? I wouldn't have stayed in. I would have gone to whatever is AV. Maybe nothing is AV. So, like, you cannot recover up on that. Okay, it's Assault Vest Magearna on FLCL's part, and he gets it correct. Softballing again. I probably wouldn't have made that play. But yeah, he gets it correct, so that's fine. He goes back in the Magearna. Now we will see if it's Flamethrower or Knockoff. He just Moonblast again. I thought he would, thought he would want to go for a different move this time to get either Flamethrower damage or get rid of the AV on this Magearna. Okay, he has Flamethrower as I expected. But yeah, this time he's just gonna spam Flash Cannon, obviously. He's just gonna spam Flash Cannon, he's not gonna let you heal again. So if he's AV Torn, he can go to that, but yeah, he goes a Magearna, so that's probably AV Mon. Yeah, that's absolutely nothing, that is AV Magearna. And he does win a potential speed tie and goes for Volt Switch. I could see him going Zygarde predicting a Volt Switch as he does make the aggressive play. Does it work out? It does not work out. He went into, oh my god, the Florican just dropped him. Wasn't he at minus one and Zygarde still died? Whew. So this is definitely max special attack. Magearna with Assault Vest, I assume, since it had Volt Switch. Only FLCL Florican is there, he's too good. He does go for a Z-move, Supersonic Sky Strike, in case he wanted to switch into Mew, because Sky Strike plus Earthquake probably would have killed the Mew. But I don't know, like, it was, the Magearna was at like minus 2 or something, so I think he didn't have to go for it. It was just in case he switched out, I can understand the play. As Magearna can take 2 of the Hydro Pumps, the Greninja is not in Ash form yet. Did this team, usually this team had like Z-move Magearna and a different Mon over Pinsir, like the Brofist team, but this time it was AV Mech. Was it AV Mech? I mean, it had Volt Switch, I didn't really. How much did the Flamethrower from the Clefable do? Flamethrower from the Clefable did 23%, so I'm actually not sure if that is Assault Vest. I kind of want to calc that. But yeah, the Magearna can go for a Florican or a Volt Switch here. I don't think he would go into his own Zygarde. That is too risky. You see what happens when you go into your own Zygarde. Your opponent updated Cannon, made a risky play earlier. Yeah, just go for Flora Cannon in case he wants to go Zygarde. It does a lot. I mean, you can root stuff here, and you, as Magina is gonna go for Volt Switch and bring out like the Clefable or something. But yeah, I do want to call how much Clefable would do versus Assault Vest. Magina. What a flamethrower. He goes on a Tornado, and he's gonna knock off the Mew's leftovers here. If the Mew stays in. And we do see it's Life Orb Torn. Kinda expected that early on, but wasn't sure after a while. But yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Something to like break feather teams. As the Mew is gonna be Defog in the last slot, I assume, because he has a Pinsir. He can also be Defog on Laddy, but I think this should have Defog for sure. Oh, never mind, he has Rocks on this. Yeah, it's probably Will-O-Wisp in the last slot and Defog on Laddy then. Because no Will-O-Wisp on you, you don't really see that. That's not a set. Like, it's either Softball Will-O-Wisp and then it's either Defog or Stealth Rock in the next slot, and it's either Ice Beam or Volt Switch or Knockoff or Psychic. I don't think he sees CMU with non Will-O-Wisp, but yeah, like Clefable gets a free Softball here. What would I do here from FLCL? It's kind of a tough position, to be honest. Because you don't want to go hard on the Pinsir and take Rocks. I mean, hard on the Pinsir is a potential play. As he does make that play, okay. Return is going to do a lot, but it's not going to kill. And how much would a Flamethrower do? I really have to put Flamethrower in here. I'm a bit slow today. Flamethrower to... Yeah, I think the Magina was AV earlier, because it would have... It did 23 and that's 20 to 24. And how much does it do to Pinsir? That's 50 to 59. So technically Pinsir can go for SD here. And get a kill if the Clef stays in. Clef is nice to keep though. Clef is really nice to keep as it resists Dark Pulse from Greninja. It basically walls the Mew and it also beats the Latios. Most likely, yeah. Because I'm still going off the Lati being Scarf. So the best way that the best that Lati can do to Clef is like tricking it the Scarf. Like Psyshock won't do much, and I guess he could still have TBF on Lati, but I'm pretty sure his Lati is just Defog trick Draco Psyshock. But he just decided to sack his Magearna. I mean, if he has DC he gets a kill, but it doesn't really matter. I think return was fine because he 2-hit KO'd a Magearna and the Landorus was offensive, so it's not like the Landorus wants to take a return. Like, and it's Hypercutter, so the Landorus would get blown away. I assume it was Hypercutter. Most Pinsir do run that. Moxie is like not really seen. Landorus is just so common, you want Hypercutter on your Pinsir. Yeah, like Pinsir is so good in this at the moment, like in this meta. If you don't have like Zapdos or Rotom. Like, there's some mons that can check it offensive, but switching to Wise Pinsir is a savage beast, even though they did nerf the Aerial Aid ability, as this is gonna go for a Hurricane or Heatwave. Since it's Life Orb, they will be able to pick off the Pinsir, as he does get a burn on the Lati, which is a bit annoying. He might trick here Britain the Clefable, because I don't think he would ever stay in here risking his Tornadus. I mean, it would be a great play staying in or going to Landorus here predicting that trick, because Landorus is Z-move and can't get tricked. Torn would take the Scarf if it got tricked, and I mean the Life Orb is nice for damage output, but he does make the Landorus play, which is either the sack or he predicted a trick. He just go for Defog. That makes a lot more sense, honest, actually, because if Kanto goes into Clef, like, if Kanto goes into Clef, your only play would be tricking it or going for Defog. So Defog is actually a better play because you want the Rocks gone for the Pinsir. I didn't think about that. The thing is, Kanto still had his Rock alive and the Rocks will just go back up now. So if he Draco there, at least he would have killed the Landorus. Or even Psyshock would have been nice. But yeah, the burn is a bit unfortunate. Clefable is just going to get the Rocks back up. Like, what else is it going to do? This is why I'm surprised why he doesn't have Defog or Mew. Like, I would either expect double Defog or at least Defog on Mew and this not having Defog at first, but then I saw the Mew moveset and probably doesn't have it. I mean, you can also click Moonblast here because he doesn't have a resist. But, like, yeah, Moonblast doesn't have a resist. You can go to Mew, but Mew, what does Mew doing back to Clef? Mew can't touch Clef. So he's either going hard pincer. Oh, he changed that move, so it's not confirmed, not Scarflady. He changed that move. Wow. That was a really nice play by Kanto scouting for that not Scarf. I didn't even realize that. So he doesn't have a Scarf, or he has quick attack and extreme speed. Man, I'm a fool. I thought the entire time he was Scarf. But yeah, thankfully I realized it before the game is over. So he's maybe Soldu. Because he didn't take... Oh, he might be live, but we don't know yet, because the attack didn't go off. He just goes for Rocks. Rocks is a safe play. But Moonblast would have been nice there to put this in flamethrower range. This Lander's going to get blown out the window, going to get 2-hit KO'd easily. It's obviously going to be Jolly Pinsir. And going to outspeed the Landers here, and afterwards Kanto can bring out his Tornadus again. I mean, he can also bring out his Latios. But Tornadus seems like a fine play to me. I mean, Latios and Draco Meteor afterwards is also nice, because FilCL doesn't have a Draco switch in. Interesting that FLCL doesn't have a Landorus, because like Landorus has so much usage. It's like on almost every team. Yeah, now that we if you look at FLCL's team, besides Pinsir, which I don't think Pinsir resists 1000 arrows, because the first time you get attacked, you don't get dropped down, so it treats you as a flying type. I think it only you only resist it the second time. So like Mew is like his main switch in 2000 arrows, so he has to be fifth dev Mew for sure. But yeah, he decides to go Tron, and I think he's gonna go for Heatwave because Hurricane is just not accurate enough to rely on in this scenario, because if you miss Hurricane you just lose. How much minus do Pinsir do? I don't think he's staying in here, but I just wanna run the Kulk. -1. Pinsir versus Tornadus, Staryon, Life Orb, the 61-72. He's going to Latios predicting Heat Wave, but Latios is going to get 2-hit KO'd from Heat Wave into Knock Off. We do know it's not Scarf Latios, he changed that moves earlier. Or because he changed that move, I don't know if my sentence made any sense. Let's go for Knock Off. This might have Taunt in the last slot and Hurricane. It might also be 4 attacks, but like either Sludge Wave or Super Power and then Hurricane. Like, Hurricane is obviously the last slot, because like, it just hits so hard. I know it's only 70% accuracy and it's like shitty to rely on sometimes, but it's just so good on Life Orb Taunt if you can hit. Like, well, that is switching in. If they're switching to Chansey, they get knocked off. Zapdos is like the only good switch, and which is why some of those carry HPIs. Because I think HPIs 2-hit KOs after Rocks, if you're Life Orb Taunt. I'm not sure if it was 2-hit KO with HPIs or if it was after Rocks that Hurricane into HPIs kills. It might even be that Hurricane into HPIs kills after Rocks. But it does go into Greninja, and this is obviously threatened out. The Specs Greninja is easily going to kill this. With a Hydro Pump. I mean, it's kind of 50-50 between Hydro Pump and Dark Pulse if he goes into Clef or if he goes into Lati here. I assume he's going to go into Clef. Because the Clef can take any hit and you can scout from there, and you can also make an aggressive play. Because if FLCL goes for Hydro Pump, you're predicting the Clef. The Latino next turn is kind of obvious, so I could see updated Kanto going into Clef here, predicting, like, just scouting what it locks himself into, and then I could see him staying in. Predicting FLCL to double into Mew. Because FLCL wants to get rid of the rocks, but he just checked the Torn, okay. Yeah, okay, see, I would have gone Clef there and gotten blown away. I mean, I don't know if I would have made the play, I'm just thinking that it was a potential play. But yes, Slutty's gonna have to click Draco unless it has T-Bolt. I don't think they carry that at all. Like, I've never seen that. Unless it's like Z-Thunder, but if you Z-move... I think this is Scarf for sure. I mean, I was wrong looking at FLCL's team, because I thought it would be Scarf too, but... It just hasn't shown any moves yet. Pretty sure FLCL wins this now. Because you can weaken the Clefable with either the Zygarde or the Pinsir and then finish it off with another Mon. You can go hard Mew here if it's Scarf Latios, that shouldn't do too much. I know the Mew is Fizz Defensive, Fizz Death. Okay, I did put Specs Lati in the cult, that's my fault. But let's just give the Mew like 56 death or something like that. How much would a Drago Meteor do if you take the Choice Specs? Oh, it's Choice Scarf, never mind. I did put Choice Scarf Lati. The cult finally added that. It only does 50 to 59, so Mew can... After Rocks, the Mew will take like... If he gets the high roll, the Mew will take 71. And the minus 2 Draco would do... I think the Mew can switch in here. Yeah. Minus 2 Draco would probably kill, yeah. So like he has to get 2 lower or mid rolls to lift 2 Dracos with the Mew. Greninja is really nice because if it comes in on Clefable, he can just blow that away. Like he can just blow the Clefable away with a Hydro Pump. Like not that it Okos, but it's gonna do so much. Just Calgary Creek Greninja versus. Let me put the Spadef out of the Clef. I don't remember 76 to 90, so this is the main reason he might want to keep this, but he sacks it, which is understandable because he didn't have a switch in. It was just if you want to sack Ash Greninja or if you want to sack another Mon. And now we can go to Mew and Defog. If he's Dragon Dance Zygarde, he might. If he's Dragon Dance Zygarde, that also might be able to put in some work, but I think Dragon Dance Zygarde. Like Dragon Dance Zygarde, unless it's ground Z move, it probably won't be able to break through the Clef. Because he would have to Dragon Dance twice to do good damage to Clef. Let's say offensive Dragon Dance, let's say plus 1, let's say plus 2. Where's Clefable, 1000 arrows? Oh, that's unaware Clef. Let me put a regular Clef. So I assume he's gonna go Mew and Defog. Yeah, exactly. I was just trying to figure out if he could go Zygarde and put in some work that way, but it's probably smarter to Defog here. Like, he's obviously gonna go Clef here. And this is kinda... Oh, he goes for Ice Beam, okay. Is he going for the freeze? I mean, I thought FLCL had this game a while ago, but this Clef is gonna be a bit dangerous. Moonblasting there is just so he can't go hard into Pinsir, and it's just the best move that Kanto has to hit this Mew. But yeah, this is gonna be a disgusting, like, PP stall type of thing. Mew will run out of Ice Beams before Clef runs out of Flamethrowers and Moonblast. And also spamming Flamethrower is an option to get the potential burn on the Mew, exactly. I mean, Mew's eventually gonna defog, but it doesn't matter because Rocks has more PP, so Rocks are just gonna go back up. Like, Flamethrower, if he gets the burn, that cancels out the Mew's leftovers. Oh, never mind, the leftovers were knocked off, so Flamethrower will do 6% every turn, which would be nice for him. Because he doesn't care if he gets, like, burned through Synchronize, because this is Magic Guard. It's kind of hard to say for me who wins. I mean, I know that he will get rocks. He will have rocks up at the end, no matter what. Because of the more PP, and we already know this doesn't even have Defog. Okay, I feel bad now because I said he's gonna go into muted Defog. I always have to mess up. It's not a Dark Ritual if I don't mess up at one point. I'm sorry. I mean, it's not like a big failure, but I'm just so used to seeing Defog Mew all the time. Like, if Mew is there, it's getting all them special attack drops. So he does have. He gets the burn finally. I was behind. He was spamming Flamethrower twice there. He does have 9 softballs left. So this is looking bad for the Mew now because the Clefable can just spam Flamethrower and with the combination. It's gonna spam Moonblast. The combination of Moonblast damage plus burn is gonna run out of softballs in a few turns and Clef. So there's 60 Moonblast left. So yeah, I feel Seattle has a decent shot at this now. Look, it's not like Mew can do any damage to Clef because he's at minus. Is it minus 4? He's so minus in special attack that his Ice Beam doesn't do anything. He can't even freeze this anymore because he He got the synchronized burn. Like, he burned him and then he got synchronized. And what else? So, like, he can't really switch out because Zygarde and Moomba should do 25 to pincer after rocks. And Zygarde obviously doesn't want to take. Like, Zygarde gets 2 hit KO'd. I think the way he has to play this is basically sack off his Mew. Sack off his Mew. And it's kind of tough for me. It's tough. I think Evelsia loses this because if he sacks his Mew, goes into pincer to weaken the. Goes into pincer to weaken the Clefable, right? He loses his pincer. And then he can finish off the pincer with the Zygarde. I think he's just gonna Moonblast here, right? So I was just trying to think what his play is, but he already made a move, so if this is not Bandit. Oh, it's Iron Tail. Okay, that's good for him. So I think it's Bandit. I wasn't sure if this is Bandit or DD. Okay, so that's good for him, because now he's in range to die from frustration. So yeah, I think Evelsia wins, never mind. Because he's gonna Quick Attack the Lottie here. And the Mew should be able to beat the Lottie one-on-one. So he did figure out the correct... I did not... The reason why I thought he lost is because I didn't think he would have... He wasn't... I thought he was DD for some reason. He's gonna softball here. And as long as there's no crits, he just wins this. Okay, nice. I mean, I didn't really mind who wins this. Yeah, Kendo's in my Discord, so I... would have liked if he won, but yeah. If he crits, he can still win. Actually, would a crit kill? The crit wouldn't even kill, I think. Yeah, actually, a crit would kill. Never mind. The first Draco that did 29 was at minus 2. So, Evelsia pulls up the win. So, basically, what I was thinking was... I don't know why I was so sure it was DD Zygarde. I just thought he didn't show his Z-move so far, and it would be DD Z-move. Because if it was DD, he couldn't have done enough damage to the Clef. I don't think he would have been able to put the Clef into frustration range. So let's just put max defense Clef to run these calcs. Because he went hard as Zygarde, so I'm happy that he didn't miss that Iron Tail, by the way, because there was already some hacks in this game. And Zygarde would not have been able to do enough damage to Clef, it wasn't banded. 1000 arrows would have done how much? 1000 arrows would have done 49 to 58. Never mind, that's calm Clefable. So 1000 arrows would have. I think 1000 arrows might have been the better play. Because it would have. Because if probably would have put the Clefable in range to die from. Man, I hate putting this to max defense again all the time. 1000 arrows probably would have put the Clefable in range to die from Mega Pincer's return. Yeah, unless he got 2 super low rolls, I think they would have done the job. But he maybe didn't want to risk low rolls. Am I missing anything here? Just want to skip through to make sure that I didn't miss anything. Like, after he switched out into Zygarde, how many months were there? There was the Clef and the Lottie. So yeah, he couldn't switch hard into Lottie. Because Lottie would die to plus frustration into Quick Attack if it doesn't die to return slash frustration in the first. But I think 1000 arrows would have been a safer way to win this at the end. But yeah, Kanto did get some hacks, but yeah, Evelsia still picked up the victory. Was there hacks against... Kanto 2 at the beginning? I don't remember. I don't think so. But yeah, I gotta figure out which teams these guys are on. I think he is on US Metro, but I'm not 100% sure. And the FLCL team, I actually forgot. Like, I actually don't know. But thank you guys for watching. I did have like one or two little mistakes there, yeah. thinking that the mew was Devok, and even after he mentioned it, like, because I'm just so used to seeing that. And yeah, this was the second Sun and Moon audio game for World Cup. Thankfully, I was able to catch it live, and I will see you with more. I know that there are games coming up on the weekend. I will keep my eyes open to see when other games are happening. And yeah, peace out, friends.